Joining me is Michael Shoebridge, a former senior defence official and founder and director of Strategic Analysis Australia. Michael, good to see you again. Listen, comparing what the Binskin report found and what Foreign Minister Penny Wong said about it, what does that tell you about her attitude to Israel?
Well, Andrew, they're like two different reports. It's a bit unfortunate that Penny Wong doesn't seem to have read the report. She's stuck with the prejudices she had when she commissioned Mark Binskin to do the report. One of the most striking things in Binskin's report, based on full access to every piece of Israeli information about it, including drone footage of the strikes, it isn't that the Israelis admitted they made a tragic mistake. They did do that. It's that they so rapidly held commanders to account. And so we had Mark Binskin, a former chief of defence here, telling us the Israelis acted to hold leaders to account in 72 hours of the strike, when in the case of our personnel in Afghanistan, no senior commander has been held to any kind of account 12 years on.
Honestly, it's just extraordinary, isn't it? You know, and then on the other hand, you wonder whether Penny Wong is tough enough on Iran, very tough on Israel, you know, not disclosing key facts, giving it some sort of excuses. But on Iran, that's actually funding the terrorist groups which started this war by attacking Israel. Here's the foreign minister today reacting under questioning to that tweet I mentioned from Iran's ambassador here, calling for Israel to be wiped out by 2027.
Those comments are inflammatory and they are repugnant and they do not represent Australia. You know, they are inconsistent with Australia's values and our views. We have, my department has spoken with the ambassador about these issues and other issues.
Now, Michael Shoebridge, is that adequate? Some tough words there, but just sending some unknown official to talk to the Iranian ambassador instead of dragging him in to, you know, face him personally and not throwing him out. I mean, this is a guy effectively supporting a terrorist outfit banned here, and we're supposed to deal with him as an ambassador?
Well, let's remember, the Iranian ambassador called Israelis a Zionist plague, so not even acknowledging that they're humans. Doesn't get much worse than that. This attitude from the Albanese government of, well, when there's a problem we don't want to face, we send officials to do our dirty work, that's exactly the same playbook we see with the Albanese government engaging with the Chinese Communist Party. They don't call the ambassador in, they send an underling or they make a phone call. And it really is a shameful way for our ministers to behave. Why doesn't Penny Wong have the authority to call the Iranian ambassador directly? It's mystifying.
Well, why doesn't she make him walk the walk of shame to her office, or even to, if she's overseas, to an assistant minister's office, so everyone, and then alert the photographer so they can shame this racist? Meanwhile, UNRWA, this United Nations organisation looking after so-called Palestinian refugees, like it has for more than 75 years, has now admitted that 9 of its 13,000 employees in Gaza, which doesn't sound a lot, may have taken part in the October 7 massacre of 1,200 Israelis, the rapes, the kidnappings, etc. They've been fired. Should the Albanese government be funding this massive bureaucracy, which has likely employed terrorists and terrorist sympathisers way beyond these 9 that we've been talking about?
No. Look, maybe other people have forgotten, but I remember when these allegations were made about UNRWA having Hamas attackers in its organisation, the government said that this was a serious problem, but then they rapidly accepted an initial report that said everything was fine and restored funding. So it seems to me that the current government is very quick to move away from criticism of even the most repugnant terrorist organisations, but is equally quick to condemn our partners and friends, like the Israelis. And that, to me, is the opposite of the right policy instinct. And we should expect better things from the government that we have.
No kidding, Sherlock. Michael Shoebridge, always great to talk to you. Thank you so much.